Excited scenes at Rarotonga International Airport today as locals and tourist operators welcomed back holidaymakers. But it wasn't just tourists on the flight. A medical team tasked with starting the Cook Islands vaccine rollout was on board as well. Pacific correspondent Barbara Drevers live from Rarotonga shortly. First, here's her report.
Touchdown. In the Cook Islands, this light rain means a blessing on an auspicious occasion. And so it is for locals keen to welcome tourists back to their shores. In the arrivals area, tour operators without tourists for 14 months wait with anticipation.
There's a mixture of feelings, but if anything, I'm more excited. I just can't wait for this to happen.
The first visitors out get a rousing welcome, as do others following closely behind, finding it hard to hide their excitement.
We're just so pleased to be able to support the Cook Islands. We've been waiting and waiting to come, and it's just fantastic to be here today. Today especially. Thank you.
And more kept coming, including New Zealand playwright Victor Roger.
Funnily enough, it's sort of like I had forgotten how to operate, you know, going through international. But, you know, it is like riding a bicycle. But great, great to be here.
And long-time visitors emotional about finally being able to return.
I've been a frequent visitor for 30 years, and it's just so wonderful.
Each visitor picked up by hoteliers and transfer operators.
As you can see, all the happy, smiley faces, so, yeah, bring more in.
There's 297 passengers on board, a lot of tourists, but also returning Cook Islanders. And these guys have come to welcome their loved ones home.
Also on board, a New Zealand medical team here to help with the COVID vaccination rollout. That's officially starting tomorrow and should be complete by the end of July. Safety is everything, and it's one of the reasons there's a limited number of flights.
We can't build the expectations up too much on this because we could be operating today and then by Friday we may have a suspension of flights. So we just have to be prepared for all of those eventualities and the contingencies that we've got that we have in place. So it's a long game that we're looking at.
But it's a start and one that's being warmly welcomed here.
And Barb joins us now from Rarotonga. Kia ora, Barb. Tourist operators not the only ones happy with today's arrival.
Well, no, and indeed the Islander Hotel where I'm standing in is extremely happy having welcomed their very first international guest in 14 months, and they're hoping to see those numbers increase. But, you know, protecting the locals is the priority. The COVID vaccine, the Pfizer vaccine, arrived on the plane this afternoon, and already the frontline vaccinators, the local staff, have already had the jab. Tomorrow morning it all swings into action. Members of Parliament, the Head of State, and church ministers will all be vaccinated. And that's really to show that the local population that it is safe and to encourage more people to get it. This vaccination program is the key to protecting this population.
Thanks, Barb. In Rarotonga, Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever.